What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another ratings review. This is the January roster update for NHL 20. If you guys still somehow do not know how to get the most recent roster update, go down to rosters, active roster. And this one's going to be January 29th. Once you have that downloaded, you'll have the newest roster. So I'm going to go through here and just give you guys my thoughts on all the changes. I think just NHL changes for the most part, and mostly just like plus or minus one. No too big of changes, although there are some. So starting off here, we have Cam Fowler on the Anaheim Ducks. He's actually gotten a plus one from an 83 to 84. He's been playing pretty good recently, so honestly, I think that's fair for him. After that, you have Arizona Coyotes here. So they've actually got a few upgrades, a couple defensemen here. Goligoski got a plus one to 83. I have him actually on my couple fantasy teams. He's playing pretty well, so I think he's deserving of that. Same with Chychrun, up one from 82 to 83. Now, I don't mind Chychrun being 83, but I still think the medium league potential for him is a bit too high. Personally, I'd have him at like a high top four. I think that makes a lot more sense. And Garland here also got a plus one, which I think was deserved. He's been playing pretty well recently. Boston Bruins here. So Char actually got a change in grading, plus one to 84. And I'm more than fine with that, especially since he's 42 years old. That'll help him hopefully keep his rating in franchise if he doesn't retire after the first year. Also, too, one other change for Boston. My boy Matt here, I don't even want to try and pronounce his last name. I know I'm going to mess up the pronunciation, but he's actually up to an 80, so I think he's been playing a bit more minutes for Boston there. Buffalo Sabres now. Eichel's actually on a plus one, now a 91. I mean, he's been having a career year this season, definitely deserving of that 91 rating. And after that, Reinhardt and Skinner here essentially swapped ratings. Reinhardt went from an 84 to 85, Skinner from 85 to 84. Reinhardt's been playing better than Skinner this year, and he's been kind of better, I think, over the past 3 years, plus he's younger, so again, don't really mind that too much. Olsen here also going to increase his rating before he got injured. Of course, he was, you know, probably one of the top, I think he was the leading scorer for rookies, actually, or maybe behind Makar only, so obviously pretty impressive. And next, you guys are the Calgary Flames, who have been playing pretty good hockey, so they surprisingly have a lot of downgrades. I don't know if you guys watched the second edition of the Battle of Alberta last night, but it's pretty awesome. Goalie fight, another fight, some awesome goals, so definitely want to see that as a playoff matchup. But Giordano and Goudreau here both actually dropped one from 89 to 88. Monahan dropped one from 88 to 87. Kachuk here, who honestly I think is probably the Flames' best player this season, didn't change in rating. I honestly wouldn't have been upset if he actually got increased to an 87. I think he's been that good this year. Lindholm also dropped one from 86 to 85. I think he'd go down a bit further. Anderson here got a plus one. Plus, he just got that new contract. I think that's a big reason for it. They want to make sure if a guy in real life doesn't really have a bad contract, then in-game it's kind of reflective. And so they wanted to increase his rating a bit so the extension makes a bit more sense. He's 22, so probably by the end of the first year, he's like an 82. Also, on top of that, I think they got a couple more increases. Ryan here up one from an 80. And then I think Dubé also got an increase. He's now 77. So again, whenever you're a guy like that's playing in the NHL, usually they try to get you at least into the high 70s opposed to a low to mid 70. After that, we have the Carolina Hurricanes here. So Andrei Svechnikov now an 86. I'm a big Svechnikov fan. I love that he's pulled out the Michigan a couple times. But this is an interesting one for me because I think Barzal was like an 85 after his rookie season. He had 85 points, 82 games. Svech had 37. And right now he's on pace for, I think, like 75 points or so. So maybe they're just more willing to give the rookies and younger players higher ratings. But compared to the past, it's definitely a bit different. Nika's got an upgrade, which I think is well-deserved. He's another younger player who deserved it, and now an 82. And a couple other players with rating changes here. Walmart got a plus one, now an 80. Also, Fogle, too. I don't know if you guys are the same as me. Whenever I see him, I always just think of Superbad. He's actually got a plus two, now an 80. I honestly thought 70 was a bit too low for him. He's a pretty good player, so 80 definitely makes a bit more sense. After that, you have the Chicago Blackhawks here. So DeBrincat is actually down one from 86 to an 85. But a couple roster updates ago, they actually increased his potential from medium top six to medium elite. And I think that's a lot more important than just a plus or minus one on his rating. Also, too, a big upgrade to Kubalik, who I think might be the new rookie scoring leader, at least for forwards, with Olsson getting injured there. He's down 81, was a 78. And then Brent Seabrook here actually dropped to a 79, if I can find him. He was an 80. Again, that makes sense. He's definitely not the defenseman he used to be, so unfortunately for him, goes to minus one. Carter Avalanche here, so Makar, definitely well-deserved upgrade, now an 85. In my opinion, he's probably like the front runner here for the Calder, even after, you know, missed some games with his injury. Burakovsky's been playing really well in the Avalanche. He's actually got a plus one as well, now an 82. Sam Girard got a plus one, 81. I think we actually mentioned last time 80 is a bit too low for him, so that's good to see. Honestly, I think he could even be an 82. Like, Ian Cole's an 81. Girard's better than Cole. I think that was like our argument. He was at least as good, but he's better than Cole, so if Cole's an 81, either drop him or make Girard an 82. I think the easiest way to know if a rating's good is just compare similar guys on the same team. Who's better on that team? Do the ratings make sense? Graves here has been playing, you know, decent. He's now an 80, so deserves that, I think. Nichushkin as well. I don't know if we can find him here. He got a big upgrade. Now a 79. He actually was a 77, so I wouldn't say he's found his game, but he's definitely, you know, gotten better, I think, playing for the Avalanche, definitely, and then his time in Dallas. And as you guys are the Blue Jackets, first player there, Werenski, got a +1 upgrade, now an 87. Obviously, I'm a big fan of Werenski, played for Michigan, but I do think he shouldn't be the same rating as Seth Jones. I feel like Jones is a little bit better, so if Werenski's an 87, I feel like Jones should be an 88, but I'm guessing just Jones has like the better defensive stats, which actually, I think Werenski has slightly better defensive stats there. So honestly, guys, it's kind of weird. I'm looking at Jones' stats right now, and you compare them to Werenski, I feel like their stats should swap. Werenski's got 5-star defense, Jones has 4.5. Jones has a 4-star shot, Werenski has 3.5. Like, I don't know, I'm just looking at it here. I feel like their stats, Werenski's, I think, better offensively, Jones a bit better defensively, but it's the opposite in game, so maybe EA can fix that, I don't know. Atkinson in here actually went down 1 to 84, but 85 is probably a bit high for him, especially this season. He's just been okay, not great, not bad, just, you know, pretty good. Borgstrand here, though, where is he? Now an 81. He actually got a +1. He's been a pretty solid player. I think 81's fine for him. He could even be an 82. Like, Nick Foligno's an 82. I think Borgstrand's probably just as good. Josh Anderson here actually dropped one again, now an 80. I'm pretty sure they dropped one in the last roster update, and since then, he's just been injured, so he hasn't had a good season to start. I think he had like 4 points in 20 games, but it is kind of weird they dropped him again when he hasn't played a game. Gavrikov here got a +2, now a 79. I feel like that makes sense. He's playing their top six, decent minutes. 77 is probably a bit too low for him as an NHL D-man. Also, Robinson here, I think, got a +2 from a 73 to a 75. Again, if you're like a younger player, you start getting like decent ice time or decent games played in the NHL, they always boost you up to at least like a mid-70. I think that's it, though, for the Blue Jackets. Now, look at the Dallas Stars. You can see Sagan there, not touched, but Jamie Benn, a pretty big drop on him from an 87 to an 85. They dropped him by 2. Obviously, this year he's just been okay. Does seem like a bit harsh though, the dropping by 2. I feel like his kind of track record before would at least make it just a -1. So I don't mind the drop. I feel like 2 might be a bit harsh as compared to like everything else they'd done. Pavelski here also got a drop in rating from 86 to 85. Heiskanen though went up 1 from 84 to 85, which I think is well deserved. One of the best young defensemen in the game. After that, I think Hintz got another upgrade now in 82. Now, he was really hot to start off the season. Since then, he's cooled off a bit, but still having a pretty solid year. And then I think Foudun also got an upgrade now. What would he be? He's a 78 now. He was a 77. Again, if you're a kind of guy like that, a bottom pair guy who's playing a bit more, not doing too bad in the NHL, I think a small upgrade makes sense for you. Now, Detroit Red Wings here. This is my favorite team. Worst team in the NHL by far, so unfortunately not a lot to look forward to. But Larkin and Mantha have not changed the ratings, so that's good to see. Athanasiou actually went down by 1, 83-82. Some trade talk around him. I'm curious to see if Yzerman pulls the trigger on that. Hronek, though, went up by 1, now an 82. And he's the best defenseman on this team in real life and now in-game. So I like seeing that. Chalewski also got an upgrade, now an 81, which I'm kind of surprised by, as he actually was playing the AHL for a bit. So I don't mind it at all, but I probably would have just left him the same. Green dropped 1, 81. That makes sense. DeKaiser dropped 1, 81. This makes no sense. He's played 4 games all year. I don't know, like, this is like the second guy they've dropped in rating who's just been injured since the last roster update. He was even injured, I'm pretty sure, before that roster update. So, I don't know how being injured, you know, makes your rating worse, but whatever. Also, after that, I think Fabry got an upgrade now, 79. And honestly, he's been hot enough. I feel like he should definitely be an 80. Like, compare him to Filppula, he's just as good, if not better than Filppula. A guy like Nielsen has been absolutely trash. I'm really surprised to see actually that Nielsen didn't drop in rating. He should be no higher than a 78. Same with Advocator. They've both done nothing. I think I saw a stat that Bernier had as many points as them, and it was like 3 assists for Bernier, and then like same for Advocator and Nielsen. So their contracts are already terrible. Might as well make them worse. Moving on to Edmonton here, you can see McDavid, Draisaitl, no change in rating or potential. So they'll probably still go 1-2 in the fantasy draft. Now Nuch, they actually dropped in rating from an 86 to an 85. Not scoring as much this year, but I still feel like Nuch has a really good two-way game, so I don't know about that. I think you could have left him 86, but 85 is still a pretty decent rating. Cassian actually got an upgrade to 81, so I thought that was pretty cool. Again, having a pretty good year, that's why I got that new contract. Not in the game yet, though, I see, so I'll have to wait for the next roster update. After that, Neil got an upgrade to an 81. This is a bit weird timing. I feel like he should have gotten it last roster update. He was doing a lot better at that point than he has, like, you know, in the months since, so I don't know, maybe like they just realized they should have upgraded him, did it after the fact. Bear here got a +2, now an 80. This makes a lot of sense. He's been playing on the top pair with Darnell Nurse. Definitely deserves that upgrade. And lastly here on the Oilers, I saw Archibald got an upgrade, now 76. Was a 74, so we got a +2. I still can't believe they're playing on the top line right now with McDavid. Like, give him a better winger. Cassian's fine, I guess, on the one wing, but you gotta give someone better than Archibald for McDavid to play with. Like, I would be so upset if that was him. Huberto, I think, is like the new number one underrated player in the league. He kind of took over for Barkov in that spot. Makes a lot of sense. You're playing in Florida. There's like no eyes on you. Now a 91. So he's actually rated higher than Barkov. So having said how he's like underrated, I would say that's more real life. In game, I mean, he's really good. But Huberto being better than Barkov, I don't know. I feel like Barkov can score just as good, but he's way better defensively. So I don't know. I think they might be getting a little ahead of themselves with the 91 rating. That puts him on par with Eichel, which, I mean, I guess that's fine. Maybe Barkov should be a 91. It's so tough, some of the ratings. I saw Trocheck there. They dropped actually in rating from 85 to 84. He's just been okay, so I think that's fine. Connolly, though, went up one to an 81. He's been playing pretty good in Florida. Brian Boyle, I saw they dropped to a 79. That's fine. I think 79 or 80 for him. You know, he's a bottom six guy. Either one's fine. Achari, though, they actually upgraded to an 80. I mean, dude got back-to-back hat tricks. I feel like, you know, you deserve that plus one at least. And I think that is it for Florida. Moving on now to the LA Kings. So no changes actually for Doughty or Kopitar, the two franchise guys. They both also still have that low franchise. Jeff Carter here, though, actually dropped from 82 to 81. Honestly, I don't think Carter's been doing that terrible this year. I think it's more the team around him. If they would have just left him the same, I think they'd be fine. After that, I think there's a couple of changes to ratings for, like, yeah, Walker here. He's a 78. Big upgrade on him from a 73 to 78, so big plus 5. Again, once you start playing regular minutes in the NHL, they always try to make you at least a high 70. Kind of like Justin Hull in Toronto was a 60, what was he, a 69 or something, maybe even less, 67, and didn't make any sense because he's actually playing, you know, decent minutes for the Maple Leafs. As well, I think it's a couple changes. Lazotte there, I believe, got a plus 1. And then Amadio here got a plus 2, and actually one more. Wah there got a plus 3, so I think these are all guys that are just like in the AHL, got called up. Gave them a bit of a boost to that rating. Minnesota here, Mac Dumba actually dropped in rating from 86 to 85. I'm not gonna lie, I don't follow Minnesota Wild too much, so I wasn't aware of Dumba not doing that well. Maybe he, you know, deserved that drop. Definitely let me know if he did, Wild fans. Koivu here dropped 84 to 83. I think that makes sense. I noticed before he was 84, and I thought that was a little high for him. Not quite that player anymore. Luke Kunin, though, if I can find him, actually went up in rating. Plus 1 from 78 to 79, so a pretty small change, but still helps him just grow a bit faster in franchise. Same for Eric Sinek here, was a 77, now a 78. I think they're both decent young players, so deserve to be high 70s. And then Susie here actually got an upgrade, plus 2 to a 77. And I just checked Dumba's point totals, guys. He's got 15 points right now in 50 games. I feel like he usually averages around 40-ish points a year, so he's probably, you know, should have 25 at this point. So I guess the minus 1 for him is probably warranted. After that, we have the Montreal Canadiens here. So Max Domi actually dropped in rating from 86 to 85. He's not doing as good as he did last year, so I don't mind that. I feel like Domi, though, probably should have high top six, especially with his age. When they're older, they're not going to grow as much. They only have a couple years left, so high top six should probably actually benefit him and franchise a lot, make it a bit more realistic. Philip Deneau, though, having a pretty solid year, got a plus 1 down to 83. I see Kolachuk there, sells medium elite. He should have low elite in my eyes. Now, 83, though, he's actually been playing pretty well for the Canadiens, so I'm glad they didn't, you know, change that rating after he got cut, then signed with them. You can see he's got the new contract there as well. Suzuki got a pretty nice upgrade, if I can find him here. Nick Suzuki there, plus 2 to an 80. I see Kokiniemi still on the NHL team. He's actually obviously moved down to the minors. Lekkinen here, I think he got a plus 1, if I can find him. I don't see Lekkinen, so maybe Lekkinen's in the AHL, but he got a plus 1. Same goes for Cousins here, plus 1 from 78 to 79. And then Nate Thompson actually got a plus 2 from a 75 to a 77. They probably just felt like 75 was a bit too low. I didn't even actually realize, but Kokiniemi dropped in rating. Was an 81, now an 80. As I mentioned, he's in the AHL now, so I feel like, you know, that probably makes sense for him. Roman Josi here got a plus 1, now a 90. Obviously, he's having a great year. I think I saw some stat. He's got the most points or most goals ever for a Predators defenseman at, like, the 50-game mark. Something like that, so really impressive. Also, too, with that new extension, they want to make sure, like, he's good enough, I think, in franchise. They gotta make sure, like, the rating matches the contract, like I was mentioning. I think that does definitely play a factor when they do the ratings. Also, too, I think some downgrades. Arvidsson from 85 to 84. Definitely, I think, what was it? The one playoff series, everyone thought he was gonna, like, be a breakout player, and he never quite looked as good as he did in that series. Johansson actually downgraded as well from 86 to 85. Same goes for Kyle Turris from 84 to 83. And Granlund down 2 from 85 to 83. I could definitely see Granlund getting traded at this deadline. He's a pending UFA. Good chance the Predators do not make the playoffs. And I don't know what it is, but, like, I really like that trade for Predators. Fiala for Granlund. Unfortunately for them, he just hasn't worked out there. Like, he was sick in Minnesota. Had, like, what, averaged 65 points a year. And goes to Nashville and just, I don't know what it is. He's not fitting there. And, like, every big center they trade for, too. Johansson, Turris, they've all just been okay. Duchesne's actually been solid there, though, the guy they signed, so we'll see, you know, what Nashville does. I'm sure they're going to do something because they're usually in the playoffs. Maybe they'll have something up their sleeve. After that, Yarncroc, though, actually got an upgrade, plus one there to an 82. Looking through the list here, Benito also got a plus one, 81. Same goes for Fabro here, was an 80, now an 81. Also, I see they actually added his headshot, so that's pretty cool to see. Obviously, always better when you can actually have a player headshot opposed to just the silhouette. And I think Grimaldi also got a plus one, if I can find him. Was a 77, now a 78. And almost forgot to, former Windsor Spitfire, I think he's an 86 now. I don't know why I'm not seeing him here. Oh no, he's an 87 now, that's why. Ryan Ellis was 86, now 87. He's having a career year. I think he definitely kind of filled in for that PK Subban absence and really just shined, gained the extra ice time, power play minutes, whatever. Unfortunately, of course, has a concussion right now with that bad hit from Perry, but hopefully he'll be back soon. So looking at the Devils after that, PK Subban here is an 86. I think that's actually what they downgraded him to before. Obviously, not having a great year, but I wouldn't probably lower Subban much more than that. A guy like him who's played so many years in the NHL, like, I'd only change the rating so much based on one season. Now, having said that, I was pretty surprised to see another rating change on the Devils, and that was Jack Hughes. They actually dropped by 2 from an 82 to an 80, which seems pretty harsh for halfway through your rookie year. Like, 82 I thought was actually a bit high to start off with. I would have given an 81. They dropped him by 2 now to an 80. I think you should just give him an 81 to start and then left it there. Like, I don't know, he's got 17 points, 43 games. He's averaging, he's gonna have like, what, 40 points a season or whatever. So I definitely like to see a bit more consistency from EA when it comes to the ratings, especially the rookies. I think Hughes is on pace for about 40 points. And I was mentioning Svechnikov earlier, I think his rookie season was like 37 points, and he was still an 83 at the end of that game at the start of NHL 20. And they have Hughes in 80, so I think that's just a bit harsh, especially too, like, if you wanna talk about the clout, the guy went first overall, like, I don't know, it doesn't quite add up in my eyes. Coleman here actually got an upgrade, though. He's plus one to an 81. I mean, is Coleman a better player than Jack Hughes? Not in my eyes, but whatever. So moving on now to the Islanders. I think last time the Islanders got like no changes, even though they've been playing really well. So happy to announce, you know, they have actually had some upgrades. But we're starting off with a downgrade. It's Anders Lee from an 85 to 84. But that one actually makes sense, I think. Definitely not having as good a year as he had last season. A lot of guys, honestly, who got paid last year, this year, they just really haven't followed it up. Anders Lee, Kevin Hayes, a bunch of guys basically got paid a lot of money. It doesn't seem like, feel like the money was definitely a bit of a driving factor for them to have those career years. But a lot of guys did get upgrades. Brock Nelson there, I think, actually got a plus two, now an 84, which he's having a pretty good year. But I don't think I would have given him a plus two. I probably would have done plus one, make him an 83. I feel like Lee would still be a better player. Same with Eberle. Beauvillier, though, got a plus two as well, now an 82. He definitely deserves that. I think he was a bit of an underrated guy on this team. Taze there got a plus one, now an 81. He's been playing pretty solid, I think, for the Islanders. Same goes for Noah Dobson. Was a 78, now a 79. Honestly, I don't even mind Dobson being an 80. I think, you know, he showed that at a young age. 19 years old, defenseman in the NHL, like, pretty impressive. I'd give him an 80. I think the last guy is Johnson. He got a plus three from a 72 to a 75. Again, if you're playing in the NHL somewhat, even as an enforcer, they're going to give you a bit of a boost there to your rating. Now, the New York Rangers here have a ton of changes. The first one, Panarin got a plus one. I can't believe, honestly, how good he's been in New York. It's just insane. So if they can, like, fill up the rest of that team, they're definitely going to be pretty deadly, especially if either Georgiev or Shishorkin turn out to be, like, a six starting goaltender, which I think at least one of them will. They'll be in a good spot. Zibanejad here also got an upgrade, now an 87. I remember the beginning of the year, he was, like, 84, maybe 85. And I was like one of the guys I thought was really underrated. I think I actually saw him in New York, and he was mentioning how, you know, he's got to get that rating up, and he's done that. So now an 87, this is a lot more fitting for him. And then we have Ryan Strom also getting a plus one upgrade, now an 84. Obviously having a career year, definitely deserves that. I think Adam Fox also got a plus one, now an 83. Same goes for Delangelo. I don't know if you guys saw, it was like a couple weeks ago, maybe 3 weeks ago, he had like a 5-6 point night. So yeah, the dude's a very good offensive defenseman. Very curious to see kind of what contract he's going to get. Also, guys, I almost forgot, Kreider here got an upgrade, plus one from 82 to 83. He's got like 35 points in 50 games right now, so I guess it's fine. It's like one of those where they didn't have to upgrade him, but the plus one upgrade is not a huge deal. And then Lindgren here, I think, got a plus three from a 73 to a 76. Again, you start playing more than NHL, if you're like mid-70s, they're going to give you a pretty nice boost. And I missed this one when recording, as EA forgot on the list, but Kapokako also got downgraded by 2 from 81 to 79. So the two former top picks in last year's draft, Hughes and Kako, both getting pretty harsh downgrades in my opinion. They've only played like 40 games, so personally I feel like you gotta give them a bit more time. I'll look at the centers now. I think they just have a few upgrades. The first one, Duclair, I mean, he's an all-star, up from an 80 to an 82. He's been really good with the centers. I think he was on pace for like 40 goals or something ridiculous. I don't think he's going to do that, but he should have like a 30 goal season. Has looked really good there. Definitely like, you know, one of the bright spots on that team. I think after that, it's actually a lot of downgrades. I don't even see him here. Colin White, minus one from 81 to 80. Another guy there got paid last summer. Hasn't been as good as he was last season. I think, too, Tyler Ennis actually got an upgrade. He's been okay in Ottawa since coming over from Toronto. Plus one from a 78 to a 79. And then Burrowicki, if I can find him. He actually got a plus one from a 77 to a 78. And then Nick Paul, of course, who wasn't AHL, came up. So he got a plus two from a 75 to a 77. And next, you guys are the Flyers. First rating change is actually Travis Konecny, playing really well. Up one to an 85. A lot of people want me to make him high top six. I might do that as well for franchise. And then Ghost here actually finally dropped one in rating from 86 to 85. I think we mentioned this in the RAS roster video. At the time, he was actually rated higher than Provorov, which made no sense. I feel like Provorov is better, so right now they're the same. Honestly, I'd probably make Provorov an 86 or Ghost an 84 to make it so Provorov is the high-rated defenseman. Sanheim here actually got a plus one, now an 83. This makes a lot of sense, playing a lot of minutes, playing pretty solid for Philadelphia. And I think there's only one other change, or actually there's two other changes. Joel Farabee, playing pretty good, younger player. I think he got a plus two from a 70, or sorry, plus one, 77 to 78. And then Myers here also got a plus two from a 76 to a 78. And next, you guys are the Pittsburgh Penguins, who I think had the most rating changes of any team. Obviously, they played very well without Crosby. I think they actually had a better win ratio without Crosby than with him, which makes absolutely no sense. Big reason for that, though, is just Malkin definitely stepped up. So he gets a rating boost from a 90 to a 91. Same goes for Letang, up one from 87 to 88, as well as Gensel, 86 to 87. I feel like all three of those guys definitely stepped up in Crosby's absence. So well-deserved upgrades. After that, there's a few more upgrades. McCann there got a plus one to 82. Rustier got a well-deserved upgrade, plus three from an 80 to an 83. Somehow the guy's got like 20 goals and 25 assists right now, just having a career year, which I was honestly super impressive. Brandon Tanev there also got an upgrade, a plus one, I believe. Playing pretty good. Same goes for Calhoun, so they're both 79s before. Peterson, I think, stayed the same. And then Marino here got a plus three, now a 79. He's been real solid on the Penguins blue line. And same goes for Bluger, was in the AHL. As kind of stuck in the NHL, so definitely deserved an upgrade. He got a plus three from a 76 to a 79, just like Marino. So again, if you're in the AHL, you make the NHL and you stick, you deserve a pretty nice upgrade, and that's kind of what we're seeing. And looking at the Sharks next year, they're playing pretty bad. They've actually only gotten two rating changes. Burns down one from a 90 to 89, which I was kind of surprised by. He's got like 30-something points as a D-man. It didn't seem that bad. So the one kind of worrisome thing is he usually drops pretty quick in franchise. It's just going to make him drop even faster, and I feel like he's not going to drop that fast in real life, so I honestly, I don't mind making him a franchise potential just for franchise to kind of keep that rating longer. And then after that, kind of surprising as well, I don't know if it's that surprising, but Marlowe here, he dropped one from 81 to an 80, which I honestly find kind of funny as it means his rating was higher as a free agent than it is playing for the Sharks. And he's not doing that bad. He's got 20 points in 50 games as a 40-year-old guy. Like, take a look here. Skating's still pretty good. Looks like the defensive stats and physical stats are the ones they dropped, but yeah, I mean, overall, it's whatever, I guess. When it's a plus or minus one, it's usually not too big a deal. St. Louis next year, Petrangelo got a plus one, now a 90. Obviously, had a very good year. He's on a contract year. You know he wants to get paid. David Perron as well was an all-star. I didn't even realize actually how good a season he's having. He's actually averaging a point per game right now, which is really impressive. And then after that, it's actually a bunch of the younger players that got upgrades. Robert Thomas here, up one from 80 to 81. I think Sundqvist here got a plus one from a 79 to an 80. Same with Barbashev, 79 to 80. And then Sanford here got a plus one from a 76 to a 77. And then lastly, McKeekern here got a plus three from a 72 to a 75. Again, 72 is a bit too low if you're playing in the NHL. So, of course, they gave him a bit of an upgrade there, making it a bit more fair. Moving on now to the Tampa Bay Lightning. So, McDonough actually got a downgrade from 87 to 86. Don't think he's producing quite as much as he did last year. So, I think I'm fine with that. The high league potential, though, seems honestly a bit strange. I'd probably have him at medium elite. Not really sure why he's the same potential as Brent Burns, say. After that, they actually got a few more downgrades, which is pretty surprising because Tampa's playing well. Kalorn, though, did get an upgrade, plus one, 82 to 83, and then Gord got a downgrade, 84 to 83, so they're the same now, which I think is pretty fair. Same with Palazzo, same. Johnson got downgraded, 84 to 83, so all four of these guys are pretty similar players, and now all 83s. Honestly, I think that's fine. And Cirelli here actually got a plus one to 81. He's been playing pretty well. I'm curious, too, like, he's really good defensively, so they got him there at 3.5-star defense. I'm not sure exactly where they, you know, change his stats to upgrade him, but he's been playing really good defensively. I think they could even make his D-awareness, stick checking, something like that, even better. Definitely one of the better two-way forwards in the game. And then Maroon here actually got downgraded as well from an 81 to an 80. He hasn't really been anything too special, so I think that's fine. Now the Maple Leafs here, I know this is the one a ton of people are wondering about. Mitch Marner there got a plus one, now a 90. Exact same rating as Austin Matthews and Tavares, so definitely pretty interesting. Tavares there with the best potential, technically at low franchise. Then Matthews high elite, which can turn into franchise. Marner there, medium elite. I feel like maybe Marner you make high elite as well. I know I did that before. You guys can let me know. Riley here, they actually dropped from 88 to 87. he hasn't been playing too bad. I think, honestly, they just kind of overrated him at the 88 beforehand. He should have just been 87 to start. Nylander there got a plus one to an 85. Last year was definitely a fluke with him kind of missing, you know, the first 2 months of the season, whatever. He's playing like he usually does. I think Nylander, honestly, could even be 86. Like, he's a very solid player. And I was talking about Justin Hall earlier. I think he got another upgrade, if I can find him here. Yeah, he's now a 79. So I'm pretty sure he started the year out at like a 69. So since then, he's gotten a plus 10. You can see they also have his extension there. And I believe one other change. Engvall there is now a 77. I want to say he was a 72. So he's been playing more in the NHL. It makes sense. Now, having said that, they still keep forgetting Trevor Moore there at 74. Like, he's just as good, if not better, than Engvall, Timoshov. Like, Moore should be at least a 78. I feel like they just keep forgetting him. So hopefully the next one they'll remember to, you know, change him. Vancouver here, I think they have the most rating changes along with Pittsburgh. A lot of upgrades here because, you know, Vancouver is first in the Pacific. Just barely, though, as it is a tight Pacific division. So Besser here got a plus one now in 86. Honestly, I thought the 85 before was actually kind of low for Besser, so I don't mind the 86 at all. JT Miller also up to an 86. Miller here also got a plus one now in 86. Actually, the exact same rating as Perron. And they're both guys that have a point per game right now, and I'm surprised they have a point per game. So it makes sense. And then you got Quinn Hughes here, who actually got a plus two. So he's now 85 overall, exact same rating as Cale Makar. I'm a big Hughes fan. He played for Michigan. I feel like Hughes, Makar, they're really close. I'd probably say Makar has a slight edge. Now, is the edge enough to make Makar 86? I don't know about that. I'd probably have Makar like half rating or half overall above Quinn Hughes. Right now, I think Makar is like number one for the Calder. Hughes is number two. Edler here, I want to say, also got an upgrade. Yeah, he did. He got a plus one now in 84. After that, Vertanen got a plus two, now 82. He's been playing pretty good hockey this year, so I think that rating was well-deserved. Pearson here also got a plus one. He's went from 80 to 81. Finally, you know, found a team where he's played pretty good with the last few teams. Hasn't quite worked out on. And I think just a couple other rating changes. Gaudette, now an 80, was a 79. Feinberg as well was a 77, now a 78. So again, the team's playing well. Usually you're going to get some upgrades. Vegas here, so Max Pacioretty got a plus one, now an 86. I know before it was like an 84 or something, so he actually didn't have a lot of trade value with that contract. Now it shouldn't be too bad. William Karlsson there actually got a downgrade from 86 to 85. I feel like Karlsson hasn't been so bad you need to downgrade him, but you compare him to other 86s, it actually does kind of make sense. Shea Theodore there got a plus one, now an 84. Best defenseman on Vegas in my eyes, so it makes sense he's the highest rated defenseman in game. I think Alex Tuch actually got downgrade from 84 to 83. Same goes for Paul Stastny there, also got the minus one. And then I think Stevenson, if I can find him, he actually got a plus one from a 78 to a 79. I would be lying if I really know how his season has been. And then kind of surprising here, Cody Glass got a minus one from an 80 to a 79. Usually I feel like they should have more leeway with younger players, like whatever the rating is, kind of, you know, give them a whole season to flesh it out. But I guess they felt like that was just too high. And then Haig here, though, again, makes that jump to the NHL. He hasn't looked too out of place. Got a big upgrade, plus five from a 73 to a 78. So I think that's more than fair. Moving on now to the Washington Capitals. So first one, Verana, having a very good season, probably his best season of his career, up one from 83 to 84. Also here, I think just a bunch of like lower rated guys getting changes. Eller got a plus one, now an 82. Same goes for Hathaway, up to a 79. And then Siegenthaler, again, kind of a thing where AHL guy makes the NHL, he sticks. He got a plus three from a 74 to a 77. And then finally here, the Winnipeg Jets. Kyle Connor got a plus one, now an 86. I really like that rating, of course, for Connor. Any, like, you know, former Michigan guy is going to like. Pionk here got a plus two, now an 83. I think he's a big reason why that defense hasn't completely fallen apart. You know, him and Morrissey shutting it down. And I believe that's actually it for Winnipeg. And one thing I'm honestly kind of surprised about is they haven't changed Dustin Byfuglien's rating. Seeing as he's not playing, I feel like they should have made him like an 84, 85. Just to lower him a bit because, you know, he hasn't been playing rather than just giving Winnipeg a free 87 overall D-man. I feel like that would make a bit more sense because you can't get rid of the contract because the contract is still on the books. But I don't know, like having him for free, it seems it's a weird situation. So I guess it is tough to try to think of a solution, but that would be, you know, my personal one. So looking at the goalies now, guys, Arizona, Darcy Kemp here again got an upgrade, now an 85. I think I said in my last video, he should be at least as high rated as Ranta because he's a starter. So they're both 85s now, which I think makes sense. When Ranta's healthy, he's pretty good. You can maybe make the argument just as good. And after that, we have changes to both of Buffalo's goalies. Allmark got a plus two, now an 83, and Hutton got a minus one, now an 80. Again, Allmark's a starter, Hutton's the backup. The ratings reflect that as they should. Columbus here got big upgrades to both goalies. Corby Salo got a plus three, now an 83. And Merzlik got a plus six, the biggest upgrade in this roster update, from a 75 to an 81. He's just been an absolute brick wall back there since Corby Salo got injured. So He deserved that for sure. All of a sudden, like, Columbus, they went from having, like, pretty terrible goalies in franchise to pretty solid goalies, both 25, both medium starter. If one of them could pull off, like, a sick year, they could definitely get one of those huge jumps where they go from, like, 81 to 86 or whatever. So I like that. Honestly, I don't even mind both of them being 82. I think they are quite similar. So rather than Corby Sala being a bit higher there. Dallas, I believe Bishop got another upgrade. He's now an 89. After that, Detroit. Howard here now an 81, which makes sense. Bernier's been the better goalie this year by far. I think Howard's got 3 wins total. Bernier's got actually decent stats considering the team he's got in front of him. So both being 81 is fair. Howard maybe should even be an 80. Like, he hasn't been too great this year, I'm going to be honest. After that, I think Florida actually had changes to both goalies. Bobrovsky dropped in rating to 88. I'm not really sure what happened. He got paid, and he hasn't been as good on Florida. And then Dreiger here is a 75. He actually got a plus 5 from a 70, but it makes sense. Like, if you're a backup goalie in the NHL, you should be at least a 75. Remember, beginning of the year, Francouz was like a 62 or something. Made absolutely no sense. Speaking of that, he actually got upgraded again, now an 81. So I think he's the player that's grown the most since the start of the year. Because I want to say he was like a 62 or something, which was ridiculous. It's like, okay, if you're going in the NHL, you're not a 62. Like, that's ECHL ratings. And if you guys are looking at LA, Jonathan Quick dropped in rating, now an 83. He's another guy who's kind of just getting up there in age, not quite the goalie he used to be. So I think that's fair. Same goes here for Dubnyk, now an 85, was an 86. Honestly, though, Dubnyk, I think, still a good goalie. I feel like it's just the team in front of him, the defense. He's just not really getting a lot of help. You could argue that, I think, as well for Quick, but I think Quick, we kind of saw the regression more than Dubnyk. After that, I believe Montreal here has a change. Actually, you're not going to see it, though. You have to go to the AHL. Keith Kincaid, minus 3. So I think he was an 80 or 81, so now he's like a 78 or 77. He's been in the AHL, and I think he, like, scored a goal on himself the other day or something, so not too great. And both the Nationals goalies dropped in rating by 1. Rene to an 86, Saros to an 80. Big reason why the head coach got fired. I saw a thing that said how, like, never has a head coach been fired when the goaltending's been getting at least a 0.9 save percentage. So basically, if your head coach gets fired, a big reason for it is the goalie not playing well, which is probably why coaches always get on the goalies. Now, next one here is actually in the AHL, so I'll show you guys Lavelle after that to see if I was right about Kincaid. But for goalies here, Schneider on the Devils, down to a 77. They dropped him by 3. I mean, he's in the AHL. It kind of makes sense. One of the weirdest stats ever, though. 33, 77, and medium elite potential still. I always drop it to low elite because I think there is a small chance he could bounce back, but I wouldn't say that chance is medium. Like, medium elite players are usually players that are basically elite. Like, there's very little chance they're not going to be. So that one's kind of weird. Also, too, I just remembered I said I'd show you guys Lavelle. I think Kincaid, like I said, should be about a 78 or so. Let's see here. And yeah, he's a 78. So again, those are two, I think, former Devils goalies. Big reason why the Devils just haven't been a great team the past couple seasons. The Rangers here, Lundqvist actually dropped the rating from 87 to 86. And then Georgia went up one, 81 to 82, which makes sense. They really have 3 goalies right now, which is kind of interesting because Shishorkin's also getting decent games started. So I think the only team in the league that's like rotating 3 goalies, but they're all pretty solid. So I mean, you might as well. Ottawa here, Craig Anderson actually dropped by 2, 83 to 81. This is a tough one. I think Anderson, he's 38 years old. He's obviously, you know, getting up there in age, but the team in front of him is pretty bad. So it's a tough way to judge, like, how good a goalie is when the team in front of him isn't any good. Pittsburgh here, Jerry got a plus 2, now an 83. Definitely well deserved. He's been playing very good. Murray and him are basically a tandem now, opposed to Murray being the starter. So he's still got a higher rating there, which makes sense. He's got a lot better track record, but recently, of course, Jerry's looked a lot better. The Sharks here, Jones actually dropped 2, now an 82. So same rating as Dell, that makes sense. You could even argue Dell's a better goalie, I would say. It's probably about equal for the reason Jones is a very hot and cold goalie, kind of like a Jake Allen in my eyes. And Marshall on Vancouver actually got a plus 1, so he's now an 87. Don't really mind that. He's been playing very well. I've actually got him a couple of fantasy teams, but I would say Demko should get upgraded because Demko's a pretty good goalie, and I don't think Markstrom's 7 overall higher than Demko. I would say Demko should probably be at least an 82. He's done pretty well whenever he's, you know, came in and started. Vegas here, Subban actually dropped in rating from 81 to an 80. Again, backup goalie. I'm not really too sure how Subban's done. I guess not too great. Washington here, Holtby actually dropped in rating from 89 to 88, so down 1. If Washington decides not to re-sign him, that'll be very interesting. Elite starting goaltender out on the market. Curious to see kind of what teams go for him. And then Samsonov, though, actually went up in rating by 3 from a 78 to an 81. So, like, is Samsonov the goalie of the future for Washington? Definitely would save them a lot of money. So I'm going to be curious to see what happens there. And then Winnipeg, finally. Hellebuyck actually went up in rating to an 89. He's a big reason why they're even competitive. Like, no defense in front of him. He's just been an absolute beast this year, keeping them in games. And then Brassois actually, just like Subban, dropped from 81 to an 80. So when a backup changes that little, like, there's not very big sample size for backups. I would have to actually watch them all the time to really know. I assume he just hasn't been posting the greatest of stats. And that's it, guys, for my January roster update review. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, leave that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. Also, crew guys, in the comments section, let me know what you thought of the new ratings. And other than that, hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.